Okay, can you hear me now? Am I audible?
It's coming.
If I see the comments, I'll know.
Yeah.
Good morning. It's audible now.
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, let me quickly catch up because we have lost time.
Yes.
Just about a generation or two back, life was totally different. When our education system was made for a certain thing, you cannot imagine how different life was. Children used to mostly be in what we call as joint families, 5 people, 10 people in a house. Just outside the house, there were clusters. There were people living in neighboring houses where children could go in and out. Children watched animals, children watched human beings, children watched nature. They had everything informal and they had to create things. Take a simple thing like games. There were no organized playgrounds and this and that. There probably one fellow would either get a bat, or if no bats were available for cricket, he would ask one of his uncles who knows carpentry to, you know, chop off one piece of wood and make it into a bat, and give somebody would get a ball and they would find some playground. They would go to that playground and they would start playing, and somebody would come and shout at them saying that don't play over here, and they would shoo them off. While they are there, the fellow who got the bat would say that I want batting because it's my bat, and then they would have a fight over it and they would argue and they would come to some conclusions. All these things, how to handle these situations, were what we refer to as life skills. Children learned from morning to evening everything to do with how to deal in a better situation in life. Within the last one generation, last 2-3 decades, what has happened is that all the children, all the families and all have got confined into now what we refer to as 2 BHK, 3 BHK, 4 BHK type of things. So now what has happened is that many of us, from adults to children, are being deprived of a certain learning. What is that learning? We refer it to it as life skills. That means the skills to lead an enriched, a happy and a fulfilling life. It is regardless of whether the person is educated or uneducated, whether the person is young or old, whether the person is rich or poor, all that is secondary. We live one day at a time. So today I am alive, I am living this life. I get up in the morning, I interact with my family members, I plan out for the day, I do a lot of things, then I move on to what has to be done for the rest of the day. I face certain challenges, certain things make me happy, certain things make me unhappy. I have to deal with all those things till the end of the day. At the end of the day, when I go to sleep, I may be happy, I may be unhappy, I may sleep very soundly, or I may toss and turn with, you know, a lot of worries about what happened today or what is likely to happen tomorrow. That's how the whole thing, you know, goes. Now, what we need to understand is that as it is, there is a great need for us to learn life skills as an additional input, because the regular inputs that were there, that village life or locality life, even in cities for example, children had all the freedom to roam around wherever you want. 10, 20, 30 years back, even in a city, everybody in the locality knew each other. Children could walk in and out of each other's houses. They could even go to a shop and take something on credit saying, you know, Appa will come and pay you later, and that shopkeeper would pat him and say, okay, take it and go. That's the type of life. Children used to walk to school running around, kicking stones, you know, plucking some fruits or leaves from plants. All that used to happen. Each one of them is a life skill learning by itself. It teaches you a lot of things. Anyway, what happened, as I said, in the last one generation, what happened is lifestyle changed completely. We locked ourselves much before all these words like lockdown and all that were heard. We ourselves had voluntarily locked ourselves down. We were living in what you know, Desmond Morris refers to as the human zoo. We created these cages for ourselves where we limited ourselves to 800 square feet, 2000 square feet, whatever it is, and then we thought life is going to go on. No, it doesn't. The same thing happened to the education system. More and more of competition, more and more of portions, more and more of testing, more and more of competitive exams, all this are a product of this last one generation. When I wanted to get into IIT, there was a very simple test which was done, no coaching, nothing. Whatever we had learned in the 12th standard, we just went and reproduced that the thing, and then somebody got admission, somebody didn't get admission, it was fine. Those who didn't get admission, there were also so many other engineering colleges, they could go there based on their 12th standard marks, they got admission. They also became very competent engineers, many of them overtook the IIT guys eventually. All that was happening. Now today, with all this competition, the that and limitations and all that, things were pretty bad. For the last 20 years at least, I have been constantly reminding people that please pay attention to life skills. And while lifestyles deprived us of learning life skills naturally, we were lucky enough to get inputs starting from Howard Gardner's multiple intelligences to Daniel Goleman's emotional intelligence to World Health Organization, a reputed body of the United Nations. World Health Organization came out with the 10 basic life skills. This was in the 90s, more than 20 years back. From that time onwards, we started holding seminars, we started talking to educators, parents, people saying that please give significance to life skills, teach life skills, learn life skills. Even as an adult, it doesn't mean that just because you are 20 or 40 or 60, you don't need to further sharpen your life skills. You need to do it. Do it as a teamwork along with the youngsters in your family. Now what happened is, we have had this lockdown business. Things have become worse in terms of life skills. On the one side, we have this debate going on, when and if schools should reopen, when and if children will actually be able to go to school, and at least the life skills that they were learning there, from the time they get into the bus and he wants to occupy a seat and one elder fellow comes and says, hey, move out, man, that's my seat, I'm going to sit here. Or if this fellow has not had a proper breakfast, he opens his tiffin box and somebody snatches that thing which is there in his tiffin and eats it off. He has to learn how to handle all those things. When he walks into this thing, he's got maybe the, you know, non-teaching staff, some security man or some sweeper, somebody saying hello to him, somebody doing something. He identifies his friends who are there, and then, you know, they laugh and joke. By the time the school starts, the bell rings and they have to suddenly learn that, okay, stop all your shouting noises. You have to stand quietly over here. You'll get punished if you talk or if you say anything. So we had to learn all those disciplines. Like that, the whole day went off like that. In between, there was that, you know, very, very interesting PT or physical education period, and the kids would be waiting desperately just to get out of the four walls of the school and go and run around and do something and come back. At least we had that till March. Now we have been deprived of it. Initially we thought it's okay. Thankfully it has come at a time when, you know, the academic year had almost come to an end. So it's okay, instead of holidays and summer vacation, children will be locked up at home for some time and then everything will be all right. But as you know, it doesn't look like it is happening. We don't know when it will be lifted, when we do not know when schools will reopen and children will go back to this lifestyle of schooling, running around, shouting, tumbling over each other, getting scolded by teachers, crying, laughing. We don't know when that is going to happen. Okay, if the child is not going to school, earlier when there were vacations or a child was not in school for whatever the reason, he would play around with neighbors, he would go and, you know, spend time in grandparents' house or in uncle and auntie's house. There were so many other things. He would go around in his colony, laughing, joking, playing with other children. He would go for some sports or some other coaching classes or something of that sort. Now even that has been deprived. There are many parents who are not willing to send their children out at all, even for activities which have officially been permitted by the government, but the fear is there. At the same time, there's a lot of debate going on, you know, when and if schools should reopen, and if schools are not reopening, how do we continue with the education? So they came out with this online education. Now online education means screen sitting in front of maximum a 17 inch, or in many cases only 6 inches of screen. Now this whole world, the life of a child, including of course lot of adults also, has now been restricted to 17 inches or 6 inches or whatever it is. Life cannot proceed that way. So on the one side, we have to abide by government regulations, whatever the experts are saying, whatever the schools are saying, online classes, 30 minutes, 60 minutes, one period per day, one period per week, or let that go on. I am not going to comment on that. But what I am very, very particular about, and I'd like to put it to you people as a very strong point, whatever else you do, there are parents who are saying, okay, in the worst case, my son or my daughter will lose 1 year. So what? He is only 5 years old or 10 years old. It's okay. 1 year later, he will complete, instead of completing his 10th standard at 15 years, he'll complete at 16 years. What's so great about it? No, it's not as simple as that. It's not that whether he is completing it 15 or 16 years. It is this current situation which is depriving most of us, particularly children, but even including adults, of certain life skills. Now what happened when this lockdown came? People took it as a sort of adventure, as a holiday. Okay, we are locked up, so what? What are we going to do? Come on, let's, you know, subscribe for Amazon Prime. Whole family will sit together, we'll get some snacks and this and that, and we'll sit and watch a nice comedy movie and we'll enjoy ourselves. Or we'll play board games or something of that sort. Or come on, everybody get into the kitchen and help mama. You know that domestic help cannot come, the cook cannot come. So mama has to do everything. Come on, we'll all pitch in. Ah, nice adventure. Come on, you wash the plate, you cut the vegetables, you do something. Everything looked very fine. Then there were these nice and proud mamas, you know, who would show their 3-year-old or 4-year-old dancing away to some, you know, item number song and all that, videographing and circulating it to all the friends. See my little one, how well she is dancing, or something of that sort. It was good while it lasted, but for how long? Can you visualize this going on and on and on and on for months? We don't know when this is going to come to an end. And what will be the impact of all this on families, individuals, close relationships and children? That is where I want us to reflect on in today's interaction. We need to enhance our life skills much more now than it was before. I don't need to repeat it. I'm sure by now most of you know it. The 10 life skills include things like critical thinking on one side, creative thinking on the other side, communication skills, interpersonal relationships, self-awareness, management of my emotions, empathy, understanding others and social skills, management of stress, management of all other emotions. All these is in simple words what life skills is all about. Just take that WHO list and go through those 10 life skills. Can you deny that each one of them is absolutely essential for the well-being, for the good growth and for the future of every individual, more so children, but including adults? So what my recommendation is, whatever the government stipulates, whatever the school says, whatever rules, regulations, you want to, you know, abide by it, you don't want to abide by it, I leave it to you as parents, adults, teachers, whatever role that you are playing. But what I want you to please supplement it. We have 24 hours. Most families are spending all 24 hours together. Work from home. So daddy, mummy goes into one corner, puts on the laptop and works. But okay, fine. There also there are gaps. You can take off. There is an end to it. You may be working 8 hours, 10 hours, 12 hours a day. You still have the balance 12 hours left. And children, they have a lot of time. Even the latest guidelines which have been given about online classes start from something like 30 minutes per week for the tiny tots, going on to 30 minutes per day for the little elder children, going on to twice a week, going on to 4 times a week or whatever it is. Now what are children going to be doing for the rest of the time, and how do they take? The one thing that I want to tell you is that whatever activities that you can think of to do as a family or with your children, or even if you are busy, if you can tell your children to do this or whatever activities you can, I want you to please ensure that those activities are not connected to any screen, neither the TV, nor the laptop or the tablet or the mobile phone. Because I want everyone to see the world beyond the screen. Today I was reading a very interesting write-up about an army colonel who participated in the, you know, what do you call that, cycling race, which involves a lot of hurdles and cross-country and this and that in America. It's supposed to be a very great event where people move from one end of America to the other end of the country on a cycle. They go up and down the hill, they go through snow, they go through slush and this and that. So it's a great event. This Indian man, I'm very proud of it, won the third prize in that. But you know something interesting? He didn't step out of his house. His cycle was that exercise cycle that we see. So he was sitting on that cycle, and that cycle is connected by the computer to the internet to something, something, something. So they make it more and more difficult, so he has to put in, like he is going uphill, so it becomes, the cycling becomes more difficult, so he has to gasp and pant and something of that sort, and then it becomes slippery or something of that sort. I really don't understand. But he won a virtual endurance race. Now if that is going to be the future, you know, I really pity what's going to happen to the younger generation. And I'm hearing a very unusual term which people seem to be, you know, talking so naturally and so easily. They are talking about this term called new normal. So they say education through online is going to be the new normal. Being locked up is going to be the new normal. Virtual cycling and racing and all that is going to be the new normal. Telemedicine, without seeing the doctor, without going to the doctor, getting their medicine prescribed and treatment is going to go on. It is the new normal. See, when I am forced to do something which goes against the basic nature of human beings, I have to do it. It is due to maybe government regulations or safety or whatever it is. I have to do it. I will do it. But the moment I give a label called new normal to it, what am I doing? I am defeating, I am giving up, I am surrendering, I am saying this is what life is going to be, please no. If I fall sick and doctor says don't get out of the bed, lie down flat for the next 1 week, you should not get up, you should not exert yourself, you should not eat more than whatever, this or that, all the regulations he gives me, I follow that because I want to get well. But I look forward to the day when I am going to get up from the bed and I am going to be independent. I don't lie on the bed and say this is the new normal. What will happen if I do that? So please, ladies and gentlemen, whatever we are going through right now, whatever you are being forced to do, do it as per the regulations, as per guidelines, as per your own, you know, security that you want to play safe. But please don't call it the new normal. It is the new abnormal. We should go back to the old normal. That is what life is all about. Okay. Now, coming to what is this? When I say life skills and you should do it at home, all that, what are we really you know, talking about? Let's start with something very simple. You have a small child at home. You want to change his clothes. You want him to, you know, have a bath and wear fresh clothes. Instead of going to the cupboard and pulling out, you know, the most appropriate t-shirt and handing it over to him and saying that, you know, after the bath, put on this clean shirt. You open the cupboard and tell him, which shirt do you want to wear? There's this blue one and there's this dark blue one and there's this green one and there's this half sleeves and short sleeves and full sleeves. Which one do you want to wear? Let him select. If he doesn't, then your antenna should go up. There is something missing in the child. He is not able to take a decision. If he turns to you and say, no, Amma, no, Appa, you please select for me, the child is missing out on something very vital. Okay, now the child selects. Ask him, why did you select that? Or if he is selecting something which is not appropriate, the weather is a little hot, and he selects a full sleeve shirt instead of a half sleeve shirt. Explain to him, you want to wear this? It looks attractive. You said you like this color, that's why you're wearing it. But are you aware that you'll sweat a little more? Full sleeves will be a little uncomfortable, you know, when the heat gets on in the afternoon. So do you know that if you select a half sleeve one, then it will be a little more comfortable and things of that sort? You know that sometimes the current goes off and the fan may not work, in which case will you be able to be comfortable? Ladies and gentlemen, that's all life skills is all about. It may look so ridiculously simple to you that you may say, what's so great about it? We can do it every day. We can do, we are doing, whatever it is. But no, please give it significance. This is where the portion of life has to be completed. Let's take relationships, for example. You can do a very simple and a very lively, life skills exercise or activity. Inevitably, let's say you have a child who keeps complaining that you are very strict, you shout at me and you don't allow me to do that, I want to watch the Cartoon Network but you are forcing me to study, whatever it is, there is this argument going on. And the child is also unhappy, saying that, why do you always shout at me, why do you do this, why do you do that, you don't tell my sister, why do you always tell me, or something of that sort. Start a simple activity. Reverse the roles. Say, you be mama and I be you. Now you tell me what you would like to tell if you were in my shoes. Let the child say. Sometimes he may even exaggerate. Sometimes he may even say things which you don't. Don't stop him or her. Make a mental note or even keep a piece of paper and jot down. Let's say that, taking the role of the parent, the child says, you are very stupid. Now you are conscious of the fact that you don't call him stupid. Don't interrupt. Keep quiet. Let him finish what he says. Have that discussion. And then say, hey man, I noticed one thing that you told me that I am stupid. Do I really use that word? Do I call you stupid at any time? Yeah, I remember that time, that when that term exam was there. Oh yeah, I think once I did. I'm not very sure. I don't recollect. But I think that's not a word to be used. I don't think that should be done. Okay, what happens when I call you stupid? How do you feel? Teach the child feeling, self-awareness, management of emotions. How do you feel? In fact, I strongly recommend print out an emoticons chart showing at least 20-30 different emotions in those little emoticons, right? And with the name of that emotion written below. Irritated, angry, furious. So when this child gets angry or he starts raising his voice, ask him, are you irritated? Are you angry? Or are you furious? Teach the child to identify and label his feelings. Simple things like that. Okay, coming back to this role play. We have now identified that there are certain words which hurt. Ask. Okay, I use these words, is it? I called you stupid, or I said you are dumb, or I said this, or I said you will never learn, or something. I've done that, no? Okay. How do you feel, firstly? Explain why those feelings come, how you feel, what happens, all those type of things. And then perhaps make another chart. These are the words which will never be used in our home. Anybody, father, mother, tata, ajji, son, daughter, nobody will use this word idiot or stupid to anyone else. Including, of course, sometimes very loosely we start using S, asterisk, asterisk, T. We are not going to use that word also. Put it up. And then say, what should be the punishment if anybody uses this? Teach the child the ability to be able to decide and write down what the punishment should be. First time punishment, second time punishment. That's how even the law goes, no? You break a traffic rule, first time they'll fine you 100 rupees, second time 500 rupees, third time they'll suspend your license or seize your vehicle or something of the sort. Same thing should happen over here. And once you do any, I just gave as an example, when you do any of such exercise, at the end of it, or maybe later, let it pass on, get busy, do something else, studies, you know, whatever, food and everything goes on, finishes off. Then say, yesterday when we were sitting and doing this particular exercise, what did we learn? Which life skill have we learned? If you say it is decision making with regard to which t-shirt, or you say it is handling difficult, handling stress, you know, what do you do when somebody is arguing with you? Or it is creative thinking, where I have to come out with new ideas. Okay, this is what you have learned. Now can we do something? Can you give me ideas of some more exercises that we can do in this particular area of life skills? Give time to the child. One day, 2 days. Go on with other activities. If the child comes out with something, give him a lot of positive strokes. Praise him and say, hey, wonderful, you have done a good job of it. If he doesn't, then point it out. Don't scold him, but say that, hey, I would have been happy if you come out. Anyway, now I will take you forward by something. We keep doing that on a regular basis, and there's a lot of things to benefit from it. In fact, I requested Purnima, our director, to just share with you quickly one or two of these type of activities or things that we do with children. We used to have till last year wonderful you know, summer camps on life skills for children and all that. Anyway, we continue wherever we get an opportunity, we do it. But just to give you an idea, to drive home the point of what, how these things are done, she'll just quickly share one or two with you. Then I will now move on to giving you a few life skills and having an open house and a discussion with you as to how we should take this thing forward of teaching life skills at home, not only for children but even for adults. So let's hear out what Purnima has to say about a few case studies here and there.
At Panjara, we for more than a decade we have been, you know, conducting life skills development camps for children. We call it for the youngs and blossoms. So blossoms is for children who are say till the age of 8 or 9 years old. And many a times we also have children, you know, the little ones who are 3 and a half, 4 years old, and the parents say that, no, why don't you just you know, take them along with you. It is so amazing that parents come and ask us that, ma'am, do you think she will understand what is angry and what is sad? And we do very small, simple activities which, you know, help us to understand that if you ask them, hey, what makes you angry, or what happens if somebody, you know, snatches your chocolate, and then she would end up telling that, I get angry, I get irritated. So we ask her that, yeah, so what do you do at such times? She says, you know what, I go to my room, close the door, and this is a 4-year-old girl, okay? And she's such a darling, such a sweetheart. She says, I go to my room, I put my face on the pillow and cry. I said, pillow, is there any particular reason? She's saying, so that my, you know, crying sound doesn't go out, otherwise I know my mother will again scold me. So if a 4-year-old child can emote herself so well, I think it is an indicator for us that we can do tremendous things with children. In fact, at this point, what I also want to share with you is that when we do these life skills, we came up with a nice idea. So while there were many parents who would be waiting for these children, you know, to take them home, it would be for 2 hours every day. So we had our volunteers who gave free services and would do life skills for the parents. So while communication for the children was happening in one room, communication for the parents was happening in the other room. And there was this boy who once came, and he apparently felt very low about himself, and he would just not think that he is good at for anything at all. So as a team, we just took it up as a task and we worked on it. I'll just share with you about what happened with that boy, while I'll just go back to the point that it was amazing to see that there were so many children who had fantastic creativity, interpersonal communication to get their tasks done. and the relationships were so good, and they would know that if a critical situation comes up, how I, you know, immediately handle it and manage it. Whereas there would be some parents who, while sharing something, would just break down, and they say, I really don't know what to do. So which means, going to say that life skills is an integral part for parents as much as for children. So this boy who came to us, we have a 2 weeks camp. So this boy who came to us, he would just not think good about himself at all. So as a team, we had a set of around 4 or 5 volunteers. We ended up just ensuring that we ask him to pinpoint every small thing which he is good at. It could just be that I cut my nails regularly, or it could just be that I ensure that every Sunday I'm oiling my hair, or if anybody comes home, I immediately, you know, open the fan switch and ask them for a glass of water, or I help my friends to complete their homework and I sit back with them. It could be the smallest of tasks, which could also be I'm not fussy about food and I ensure I don't waste food. I ensure that I help my mother to clear up the tables, I wash my own plates and spoons. It could be something as simple as that, but when that got pointed out for that boy, it created such a magic for him that he felt that yes, here there are someone, these people who are so much not judging me and who are ensuring that, you know, they are finding out what are the smallest but yet simplest and nice thing which I am very strong at. You know what, ladies and gentlemen, at the end of the 2 weeks, he told, you know what, you are giving me one certificate, but then I am taking two of it with me, because one was the old one and one is my new one. So both of us are getting these certificates today. So what did we do? Did we do any magic which you as a parent could not do for the last 15 years? No, absolutely nothing. Because you know your child very well, you know your ward very well inside out. So what happened in those 10 days, in those 2 weeks? It's just that we all made a very nice attempt to ensure that that boy was taken in totally with full acceptance and without judging him for anything at all. And that is the magic that we can see by ensuring that we impart the right life skills to children. And moving on, we will be taking your questions and continuing our topic on teaching life skills, teach life skills at home. And the second part is very important, not just for children. So over to Dr. Ali, who will be answering your questions. Please feel free to seek any clarification. Thank you.
I'll tell you why the second part of it, of what Purnima told you just now. Because we have actually seen and experienced people saying, you know, when I started off this activity or this game or this exercise with my child, let's say handling stress or criticism or how to handle conflict or anything or how to be assertive, when I started off this activity, I automatically realized that I can now handle the criticism or the unpleasantness which I faced from my uncle or my father-in-law or my so-and-so. Adult to adult also, I have learned a few things. Not only that, I have this person in my family, an adult, who has been very unreasonable, and I always used to get irritated and think very negatively. But now I learned how to handle him or her and how to interact. And when I started interacting better, now I realized that the other person is interacting much better with me. This is how it goes. The other thing that I want to tell you before we start off on the open house is that, you know, do not label this as life skills training or classes or something. Children don't like that. They say history, geography, trigonometry, Kannada, biology, mathematics. Now you're adding one more subject. No. Just say that we are going to do some activities, we are going to play some games, which is going to bring about a variety, which will, you know, give you a relief from all the mundane routine that you are doing nowadays. No, every day is more or less the same. So we will, you know, start moving into some sort of activities like that. Similarly, as I told you, do not label that, okay, today I'm going to take up self-awareness training, or today I'm going to take up such and such a training. That is what is very, very important. Keep moving from one life skill to another. You know what is the purpose. As I told you, when you tell him to select a t-shirt, you know why you are doing it. You are teaching him autonomy. You are teaching him decision making and things like that. But you don't have to say that. Make it very informal, very lively, and say, I want you to select. Hey, you are a big boy man. You are already 4 years old. You can do this, this, this. Whatever it is, encourage the child and do it. In the end, you ask him, why do you think I insisted that you should select which t-shirt you should wear? That is what we call as decision making, you know. Tomorrow you'll have to decide what career I'm going to take up. Tomorrow you're going to decide which city or which country you want to live in. Tomorrow you're going to decide so many important things in life. So for that, I'm doing these activities with you so that you learn. So we have been piling up a lot of these things. We go on adding. Every time that we come across something or the other, we keep adding those. And that is what we are compiling into this program, which is not meant for children, which is meant for the parents. We want you to learn how to impart life skills, you know, at home to your children or whoever we are talking about. That, of course, my colleagues will tell you in the end about how what we are doing and formulating. But I will be very happy if you start it off right now, in case you have not started. I know that there are a lot of parents who have been doing this very effectively, and I'm very happy whenever I get this sort of feedback. To them, all I would say is, enhance it because of the current situation. Those who have not done it very seriously or have one odd time done it and then forgotten about it, please make it a regular daily activity. It's like when you want to exercise, you have to exercise every day. You can't say I'll exercise once a week or something of that sort. And those who have not done it, please go ahead and start off immediately. If you need any guidance, you get back to us. We will help you in whatever ways we can. Navina says, if I have conflict with another adult in family and child sees that and I am unable to resolve that conflict, how to teach the child about it? Yes, it happens very often. We also get some children, you know, who say that my parent is like this, my teacher is like this, but I cannot, I'm a child, I cannot protest, I cannot change them. We have to teach such children coping skills. How to manage your own self when you cannot change. Okay, there is this teacher who you feel is partial to you, or you have this parent who is very strict to you, or whatever it is. Now, how are you going to be able to deal? Give that positive stroke of saying that the more you learn how to handle this person in your life, the easier it will become for you to handle any difficult person in your life. And then teach these coping strategies to the child, how to manage the stress, how to manage the, you know, situation which cannot be changed, how to be assertive, those type of things. Anupama says, I feel it's easy to make children learn, but very difficult to make parents learn same life skill and how it helps. What steps can I take to do the same? You just have to create more of an awareness. See, many of us, when you say parents, we are people who are never taught life skills. That concept was never taught because their parents at that time thought that life is simple. The child roams around, finds out, and, you know, gets to learn sort of on the job, as they say, you know. So by living, you automatically learn life skills. It was a fact 2-3 generations back, but now you have to slowly infuse it. There are parents who will be very struck and who will just not acknowledge. Let them go. But if you have some parents who say, what is so great about it, why should we do it, why am I wasting this time? Instead of that, I'd rather my child learns, you know, mathematics, which he is very poor in, or he brushes up his language skills, or, so that he'll get higher marks and all that. Slowly keep working so that you can bring that person down. Ovia says, I'd like to do life skill course and counseling course in Banjara. Yes, we will definitely get back to you and we'll tell you what it's all about. The prime thing is, to number one, understand the need for this. Whatever you have experienced in life already and what you are experiencing now in life also, you know, the need is very much there. So please become convinced about the need. The methodology is not very difficult. Let me assure you of that. Not only we are there to help you, once you start practicing it, no, a lot of things will automatically come to you. When you try out one activity, like I told you, reverse the roles and have an argument or something, or That will give you an idea, okay, you know, when Tata comes and he is very strict and all that, you get upset. Okay, you become Tata and I'll be you or something of that sort. Come, let's talk about how we... It becomes a nice game. People laugh, joke about it and things of that sort. If there are other family members, involve them and say, hey, when Tata talks like this, how will you do something or whatever it is. It can be done in a very lively manner. And this, in fact, this is also a way of teaching adults. When you say that, you know, do it with your child, the adult thinks that he or she is teaching the child, but the adult is also learning life skills. And when the adult sees the change in the child, the adult realizes that this is definitely very useful. Nagashri says, I have a unique issue when I start discussing simple choices, what my 15-year-old daughter does. She says directly, Amma, please don't start your counseling skills for this simple choice what I made. Before, she used to participate in discussions and things of that sort. But, okay, now the point is, it does happen. To a lot of our students, one of the things that they have always felt is, just because they did a counseling course, and now they talk to their children, sometimes to their own spouse, and they say, hey, don't practice all these counseling skills on me and all that. Accept it and say, see, when I went to learn counseling or when I went to learn life skills in Banjara or wherever I learned it was not to come back and give you a bhashan or try to impress upon you that I am great or something. I actually believe in it. So what I am saying is something so fundamental, so basic, that it is something that I believe in. Now, supposing I tell you that eat healthy food, you know, don't eat oily food or don't eat food for this thing, it's not because I went for some nutrition course or something. I believe, I love you, I care for you, I want your good health, and that is why I am telling you this. Of course, I am now reinforced with certain knowledge and certain skills because of which I can talk with a little more authority to you. And the best thing to do is to say, okay, if you don't like my way of doing it, how would you do it? How would you respond in my place? This is a wonderful way to make people responsible. I'll give you time. Don't have to reply to me today. Take one day and tomorrow at this time we will meet. You tell me. If you are feeling hesitant to talk to me about it, write it down and give it to me that this is how I would handle the situation. The more you encourage the other person to think for himself or herself, you know, explore, find out, the better these things are. Uma says, parents feel difficult to keep functional aspects of life skills as they are involved in many activities to attend. How do we address it? Yes, Uma, it's very simple. If you have a small child, you are going to prepare the clothes of that child and you are going to pull it out of the cupboard and you are going to tell him what to wear. It has nothing to do with being involved in many activities. This is part of your life, isn't it? But only thing I am saying is, when you are doing that, please spend maybe 30 seconds or 60 seconds more to stop and tell him, please select which thing you want, including even, you know, studies or homework or what are they giving nowadays, those worksheets that are being given to children, anything of that sort. What do you like to do? What is it that, yeah, I don't mind the worksheet of this subject, but that subject is so boring, I don't like that teacher or something. Let the child come out with those feelings. Let us see how we can explore on that. Teach the child how he can, you know, alternate it and do whatever that sort of things. Parents should know importance of labeling emotions. I remember one of the parents came to me and they said easily, why she feels sad every time. Sab kuch to dete hai, bachon ko to rone ki aadat hai. It was really sad, their beliefs are limited. We know that, we are aware of that. But let's not be pessimistic, let's not write off even these parents, they are ignorant, they have not been taught these things. So if we can just create that awareness without accusing them or something of that, without being bitter with them, not all but at least a few of the parents will learn. Start spreading this among your near and dear. If you have brothers, sisters, cousins, neighbors, colleagues, whoever they are, start spreading this message of life skills and its importance.
Yeah, Ali, Anushri is asking, what if parents are busy with their work and they do not have enough time to spend with their children? Can they still teach the child life skills?
Very much. How? It is the quality time and not the quantity time which is important. Please remember, you are sitting over the dining table and you are having food. You, however busy you are, you do take time off for a meal, isn't it? Use that to the best of your knowledge. Instead of discussing some movies or politics or making small talk or gossiping or something, talk about something which is meaningful like this, which will get across a message where you will learn, the child will learn each one of those things. Teenagers, don't engage in conversation with parents. Is it too late to inculcate? Not at all. Teenagers, don't engage in conversation for parents. Next week, in fact, next Saturday, we are going to have a session on how to live happily with your teenagers. That's the time when I'll go more into detail. But I'll tell you one basic thing which teenagers say whenever we talk to adults. Adults don't listen, they only talk. If you learn to listen to your teenager, just say, I want to hear you out, and you have. First time the child will say, no, I don't want to talk to you. Fine, next time, third time, fourth time. If you show your sincerity, it's a lifelong process. It's not a one day or a 1 month, process. That's how it should be done. Poonam says, how to stop grandparents helping children to do daily chores when we as parents want children to do it on their own? Talk it over. First thing is talk it over with the grandparents, saying that life has changed, circumstances are changed. Tomorrow the same kid may go to a totally different environment, city, country, where the person may have to do a lot of things differently. Can we sit and discuss this out and all that? If in the worst case the grandparent is stuck with their own ideas and they do not cooperate with you, quietly take the child aside and say, I am your parent. There are certain rules which I make and I want you to follow. I don't want to argue with my mother or father because they are my parents. I give them a lot of respect. But I would like you to follow this ground rules as far as the house and housework is concerned.
Yeah, Ali, Bharati saying, how to handle adults playing power games. Everyone wants to be on the top.
Yeah, and that's the reason why when children grow up and they become adolescents, they want to have the power game also. So parents who come and complain that my teenager is very arrogant, he is very rebellious and all that, a lot of it he has learned from you, unfortunately. So please become aware. When do you do power games? When you feel insecure, when you're not confident, when you have low self-esteem, when you feel isolated or lonely. Work on those issues rather than trying to do power games and getting somebody under your control. If you feel like having somebody under your control, please work on that one person with whom you have to live 24/7, and that is yourself. Do that power game with yourself. Gain total control over yourself.
Ali, Neha is asking, which is the life skill as per you that should be really emphasized in the given scenario?
It's like this, Neha, that which wheel of a car is most important out of the four wheels, right? All four are important. Now you have four wheels in the car and the car is running. Do you realize that you also need to have a steering wheel which will change the direction of the car? It need not be as strong and it need not have the tires and tubes which a actual wheel has, but it does play a significant. So there are times when this, what I would like you to do, Neha, and everybody else, is spread it out. Take up all the 10 life skills and the associated ones. What we have done is that we have identified so many areas which are come out from these basic 10 life skills, but which are equally relevant, particularly under Indian conditions and all that. So keep adding to that. And then focus on what the needs of your child is today. If you have a child who is very, let's say, shy and introvert, who gets bullied or something, focus on that. If you have a child, on the other hand, who is very loud and is all the time talking and imposing himself on others or not listening to anybody, then you focus on that. So identify, take the trouble of identifying what are the needs of your particular child based on his or her age, and give more importance to that.
Anything for the current scenario, she's asking right now.
No, there's nothing like that. That's what I'm saying. Scenarios will change. People are making this out to be so big an issue, you know. Yes, it is important. Things have really changed because of lockdown or whatever it is. But these sort of things in my life, I assure you, we have seen it. And if you have, you know, grandparents older than me also, you can ask somebody who lived in Second World War, somebody who lived during the independence struggle, somebody who lived in the 1962 Chinese aggression and earthquakes and tsunamis and all that. All that come and go. Even right now, part of our country is being ravaged with floods, and the issues that they are facing are 10 times more important. But regardless of everything that happens, life skills has to go on. Just keep adapting, Don't give too much importance. Don't think that there is something called COVID life skills. No, there isn't. Please. Life skills is to do with life. It has nothing to do with the pandemics.
Yeah, Ali, Musrat is asking, if there is a conflict between siblings who are adults, then how do parents resolve it, or can the parents, what can they do to keep themselves, herself impartial? Yeah.
Yeah, impartiality always has to be done, and it has to be focused and imposed also. But you make one small comment saying that, no, your brother loves you, no, he's not saying it with bad intentions, finished. I feel that you are being impartial. Why are you defending my brother? Why aren't you? Do you think I don't love him? Do you think I'm not thing? So you have to be very sensitive, very careful. Focus on that sibling whom you are talking to. Do not mention anything about the other sibling. Hear out, even if this particular sibling is saying something which is downright wrong also, just let it the steam out. Ask, what would you like to do? And then say that, do you realize how difficult it is for me as a parent? Do you realize how much I get pained sometimes if I see you people disagreeing and things of that sort? I feel that, have I been a failure? I turn it to myself. Can you please help me to get more at peace by being better? I am willing to cooperate with you. I am willing to help you in whatever way. But as I have been saying, the earlier you start on life skills, the better it is. So if these people have already become adults, be aware of the fact that it may not be that easy. As it is with two small children who are having sibling rivalries, and you can tackle it. If you tackle it now, this is one of the issues. You don't tackle something like sibling rivalry when they are children. When they are 30 or 50 years old also, they still have sibling rivalry. Prevent that from happening.
Yeah, Sunita is asking, can we have a session for adults?
This session is what we are planning out, and what we are structuring out is primarily for adults. As I told you, while we will be talking about activities and what to do with children and, you know, how to impart that, but as I told you, it will be a wonderful learning exercise for yourself. You cannot teach somebody self-awareness unless and until you stop and increase your own self-awareness. You cannot teach somebody conflict handling unless you learn how it's going. So you will automatically, I assure you, you yourself will say, oh, I'm teaching this conflict handling. But when I got into that conflict with that customer or that colleague of mine in office, did I deal with it correctly, or did I make it unpleasant? Could I have done it in a better way? So in that context, you will also learn.
Yes, Ali, the next thing is, teenagers don't engage in conversation with parents.
Yes.
Is it too late to inculcate life?
No, it isn't. That's what I said. Only encourage them to talk, keep quiet, don't criticize. The moment they start talking, don't say, when did I do that? Why are you saying that? Give them a chance to hear out. If they have not been used to it, if they have already clammed up, it will take a long time, but you can succeed if you are patient. Navina says, I think in this lockdown we should work on our life skills and equip ourselves and children and bounce back when the lockdown is over by being better version of ourselves. Navina, I agree with you 100%. But why is all our life revolving around this so-called lockdown? In fact, to a great extent, in cities like Bangalore, the lockdown has been lifted. It is only 25% of what it was, in April. But why are we locking down our minds? That is what I want you to please understand. There is a lot we can do. I just wanted to set you off on the path of thinking, today. I want you to start exploring, finding out different means of doing it. I'm not saying that you have to take only what we are saying or what we are trying to inculcate. Those are only ideas that we are giving from where you can create your own ideas and things of that sort. But for that, one very important thing is you need to have a positive mindset. You should not get pulled down by this lockdown, corona, so many lakhs died, so many infected, so many this. Just forget it, it's happening. There are authorities who are taking care of that. All you need to do is to take the precautions and follow the guidelines. So wear your mask, sanitize yourself, do whatever has to be done, protect yourself, keep distance. Very simple rules. You just follow that. Beyond that, there's nothing you can do. If it has to happen, it happens. I personally know people who became COVID positive. Within days they walked out of the hospital or whatever it is, and they are leading perfectly normal life Nothing happened. In fact, there were other ailments which they have suffered which were far more serious and life-threatening. So it's not the end of the world. Let us not focus on that. This negativity, you know, let me wind up by telling you a very interesting anecdote which a Jesuit priest had told me. There were these two young priests who had just been ordained into the priesthood. And of course, they take the vows of chastity and humility and poverty. They were sent to a remote village, saying that those villagers don't have any inputs. Go and help them and, you know, create a better life for them. So these two young men were walking through. There was no road to that tribal village. They were walking through. They came across a river over which to cross. There was no bridge. Somebody had just cut a tree and put a log of wood. You had to walk over that log of wood to reach the other side. Now that's quite dicey, isn't it? You can slip and fall down. When they reached there, there was a very pretty young girl standing there, very scared to climb over that. The first priest realized what's happening and told the girl, "Don't worry, dear, I'll see to it that you go." He lifted her up in his arms, got onto the log, walked over, put her down. She said, "Thank you," and she walked off. The second priest crossed over. They continued walking, half an hour. After half an hour, the second priest could not control himself. He said, "Father, you are an ordained priest. You have taken a vow of chastity. Is it right for you to lift up a pretty young girl in your arms and carry her like that? Do you think you've done the right thing?" The first priest said, "Yes, Father, I think I should have avoided that. But I picked her up, carried her over in 30 seconds and put her down. Why are you carrying her in your mind for the last 30 minutes? That is the takeaway, the last point which I wanted to say. And now over to Seema to give you a few quick wind-ups on this session.
Thank you, as usual, Dr. Ali. That was a really, really nice session. And as you can see behind me, Certificate in Life Skills Training. So Banjara conducts a crisp 12 sessions of training for any of you who is interested. Actually, it's also like the Train the Trainer program, wherein, you know, you can come and learn, you know, the life skill training presentation. We focus a lot on your presentation skills and, you know, your confidence building and things like that. And this, you can further go and take training sessions for children and other adults in either your organization or wherever you would like to. So basically what we do is it's a 12 session thing, which means that for 6 weeks, you know, usually on Mondays and Thursdays, we have this, and we focus completely on the presentation. It's more of a teamwork, role plays and things like that. So, you know, many people also want to, you know, they have the stage fright and they want to, you know, get over that. So for all those things, you know, this kind of a training is quite helpful. And of course, we have the DCS, Diploma in Counseling Skills, you know, admissions which are on for this year, and planning to start as soon as we get a go ahead from the government. You know, end of July is when we are looking at doing this program also. So we keep having a lot of these programs and sessions and things like that. What I would like, you know, to request you all is to just like our Banjara Academy page. And you will keep getting updates on the various activities which keep on happening in Banjara. So we are always constantly looking at improving, you know, the lifestyle or a lot of these skills, you know, developing the skills in everybody. And also, like we always say that, you know, the books and booklets are available. In fact, we have, Dr. Ali has written some very, very interesting and very short. See, look at this, life skills. There is one book here and another one here. Very, very practical tips you can get. All these booklets are available here, and you can walk in anytime. You can even order online. You can just call us up and check out the procedure of how to do that. So books, booklets are available. Training sessions are there. Talks are there. So we have a whole lot of things happening here all the time. So please, you're most welcome. And see you all next Saturday. Next Saturday, again, we come with a very interesting topic. on teenagers, you know. So you're most welcome again, and thank you once again for your valuable time on this Saturday, and meet you all again next Saturday. Thanks a lot.